All right, ladies and gentlemen, as our flagmen discuss their rules over here, I want to thank you once again for coming out to the third annual Stover Truck and Tractor Pull. While I do apologize about the delay, we are ready to get things underway. First up, we've got Myron Fisher coming out here in his 1949 John Deere coming out of Stover.
Have his way at the last one.
I believe Myron just said he's going to go ahead and turn that one down and run it again. Now this pretty much is a new track. Took a lot off the top, brought in a lot of brand new dirt. I mean, just over the last couple weeks, been hauling it in and getting it put down, and it looks a thousand times better than last year, don't it, Chad?
Okay, this is Blake Krasler from Coal Camp. I think this is a 77 out of the Dollar Book. No, it's an 88.
Oh, we take it out from the brush hog every now and then.
So that puts Art Sims, the third, out of Sedalia on deck next. That's Art Sims coming out of Sedalia.
Youngest one of the Art Sims. They used to pull John Deere's pretty well strictly when Art II and his dad pulled. They pulled, had a real tough 730 John Deere that they pulled. An 861 Ford. Back years ago when I pulled an 864. And a B John Deere was pretty good competition at that time. This is an 861 diesel. First pull. So he's looking at pulling 95 feet. I guess he's wanting to pull more than 205 feet. I guess is really what he's wanting to do. He wants to win this one. This is a B with the creeper low in it, so they go. We can really go slow in first gear.
Oh, I don't know about that.
And it sounds like it might be revved up a little more than what stock would be.
Yeah, but that's right.
is good for first place, Martin Fisher first, Blake Krause second, Art Sims the third, and third place. Iron Pole 226, Blake Krause 205, and Art Sims the third, 199.2.
It means next on deck we've got our 5500 stock class. So for you four drivers in the 5500 stock class, go ahead and get them lined up so we can get you ready to go.
We shot 500.
Okay, Blake Krause, Bradley Noling, Art Sims the third, and Rick Windsor.
Covering the board on this next class, we've got an Oliver, an Alice, a Ford, and a Farmall. Trying to get a little bit of everything. From Cocamp. I think this is the same tractor we pulled in the last class, I believe, an 88 Oliver.
Good luck to the sheriff. Go camp, head out.
Now, I think this is the first time I've seen Bradley pull this tractor without his Lucky Alice Chalmers tattoo showing on the shoulder.
Make sure you don't hit nothing. They don't have very good track record.
Ain't not big enough.
Broadside of Matthew Clifford's pickup down here in one of the tractor pull California with a golf cart. I mean, T-bone that something as hard as you could. Reed Nichols, you know him.
Don't jump.
No, I didn't. You know Reed Nichols. Don't pull that old 730 down here. Anyway, he had that golf cart there. You know what? He said, green. Buddy, I'll let you go. Oh, he'll be fine.
Distance of 241 feet, 2 inches, 241.2. On deck, Art Sims, the third.
Well. Yardstick for it. Took off. It sure did. Yo, Brian was telling me that. He said, I don't know what went on. I said, well, let me tell you.
He's been pulling since he was 5 years old. I have seen him pull when he was about yay tall. And it was on a hand-clutch John Deere.
It didn't it come out of Mississippi or somewhere? North Carolina?
Rick usually pulls every year at Florence. We have a step-on sled there, which is altogether different than the mechanical sled. People provide the weight. They have a chair setting down the track, and people get on when they get to every 10 feet. Somebody gets on each side. Rick pulled 273 feet, 8 inches, 273.8.
Man, that's pretty good for a Division II tractor, ain't it?
Not bad.
Not bad
at all.
Right now, that's good for first place. Brad Manola, second for 241.2. I see that Mike made a good decision to re-pull him.
I should have brought it. Well, I ought to be able to go down there.